guys, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be doing a part 4 of my fidget toy series. So before I get into it, I'm going to be talking about my giveaway just briefly. So I'm going to be making a video all about the giveaway once I hit 1,000 subscribers, what's going to be in it, how to enter. And I'm not going to be doing it through TikTok now because a lot of my followers don't have it. That's completely okay. But yeah, without further ado, let's go ahead and get straight into this video. For this first one, you're going to need some of these little clotheslines. I don't know exactly what they're called. I think they're called clothesline clips or whatever. These are small ones and also they're colorful. That's why I wanted to use these. So I'm going to be using all of these and I'll show you how to make a DIY tangle out of these. So to do this, you're going to get your little clothesline and you're going to slip it, this little wood piece, off of the middle. And then on the other side, do the same thing, just slip it off. And then you're gonna have this. Do that to all of them. Now that you have gotten all of these, start with one. And what we're going to do is get another one and you're going to kind of separate this like that. You're going to get the other one, put one of the pieces through the little hole, and then you're going to extend this one and put it through the other little hole. And then you'll have this, and you're going to do that a few more times. And by a few, I mean however many times you want. So I'm going to finish that up and then show you guys the finished result. I have finished my DIY tangle and this is what it looks like. I would recommend this one if you want to bring this in public because it's smaller and you can just take it around with you and most people wouldn't notice. This one is really great. I'm really surprised I haven't done this one yet. I really hope this one helps though because this one's pretty great and I definitely recommend. For this next one, I'm going to get one of those, you know, those like bracelets or hair ties that you keep around. I had already cut mine in half, but usually it would look something like this, a little larger. So what you're going to do is you're going to get one of these and you're going to cut it in half like I have already done. And you're going to measure out a little circle and then cut it right there. Next, you're going to put a little blob of hot glue right here. And then you're going to put your other side and attach it and hold it there until it dries because you will not be able to let go until it is dry or it won't work. Okay, then what you can do is put it on your finger, and this is like kind of one of those finger things. I don't know what they're called. I'll put the name up on the screen when I figure it out, but it's basically like one of those little finger things that you run up and down your finger. But yeah, this one was super easy, quick, and simple. So yeah, if you're looking for something like that, you can make this one. Okay, so for this next one, I'm going to be making a single popper. So like a pop it, just one, but just one. So I'm going to get this sticky note. You can use any piece of paper. I just wanted to use a sticky note because it's more colorful, but just make sure it's thinner paper. Oh, then cover it with tape. Scotch tape is recommended, but I'm going to be using this tape because I can't find my scotch tape. So just cover it with that. Okay, so here it is. I taped up both sides. I did cut it a little bit as well. So now what you're going to do is you're going to get your scissors and cut a slit like right there. Okay, so then what you're going to do is kind of put it over like that. And then you're going to tape it right here and also on this side. Okay, so then what you're going to do is cut it out kind of into a circle shape. Okay, so now what you're going to do is you're going to get a piece of cardboard like this, and you're going to cut it into a square larger than your circle poppet thing. Okay, so then what you're going to do is you're going to cut out a circle the same size as your poppet. So just trace it like that and then just cut it out with like an X-Acto knife. Okay, so then what you're going to do is make sure it fits in. You're going to put it inside. Then you're going to get your glue gun and put it around the circle so that you can secure it in. You can also do it on this side. Okay, so now that the hot glue is completely dry, I have this little poppet. I love this so much, honestly. Like, it's amazing. The only thing I would change about it is I would put like probably another piece of cardboard here and like with another hole because it would make it more sturdy, but I could just do that. I mean, it's simple, just throw it on. But yeah, this is a really great one. And if you wanted a actual poppet, like with all the thingies on it, comment down below. It would have its own video on itself, but yeah, comment down below and I will definitely do it if you guys want me to. Okay, so for this one's actually really fun, super simple. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna get a marble, or I got this large pearl. You're also gonna need one of these binder clips or whatever. I don't know what they're called, but you're going to put this in the center like that. And then what you're gonna do is get like a rubber band. I'm gonna get a loom band. I'm gonna get 3 loom bands and I'm going to tie it on like this. And this is a super duper simple, easy fidget, and it just rolls back and forth. If you want it to be more flexible, just don't tie it as much. But yeah, this one's super easy to do, and it's really nice. I'd prefer to use a marble, but I don't have any marble, so I just used a larger pearl. But yeah, I definitely recommend this one because it's super small, super easy, and yeah, probably have the supplies at home. Okay, so for this next one, all you're gonna do is get some popsicle sticks and some super cheap loom bands. First, get 2 loom bands, grab your sticks and put them in a cross shape. Oh, sorry about the noises in the background. But what you're gonna do is you're gonna put it across and you're going to loop it a few times until it feels like tight. Nice. And then what you're going to do is you're going to get 2 more of the bands and you're going to put it in the center like that. I hope this is making sense. Not the best teacher, but you're going to loop those around a few times. And then what you're going to do is you're going to get 1 more rubber band. You're going to then put it around on top just to seal everything in and place everything in place. Then you're gonna have this like super cool, like, I don't know what this is called, but I think it's really cool. I know it seems kind of weird, but here's the other one I made, and I really think these are cool, honestly, because they're kind of like, I don't know. I don't know what it is about them, but I think they're pretty cool. but yeah. That was it for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Sorry if these were more simple, but I wanted to show some that were more simple and had more household supplies because I wanted to make sure that everyone can be able to make them. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Get me to 1,000 subscribers so I can do the giveaway. And yeah, love you guys so much. Thanks for watching. Bye!